The fight is about whether he, as a Sikh, is going to be allowed to wear his turban in India. He, as a Sikh, is going to be allowed to wear a kada in India. He, as a Sikh, is going to be able to go to a Gurdwara. That's what the fight is about. And not just for him, for all religions. What the RSS is basically saying is that certain states are inferior to other states. India is called a union of states. In the constitution, it's written clearly. Union ये सब अलग अलग हैं और इन सब में से एक सबसे जरूरी है, एक सोच सबसे जरूरी है, उसकी उसका हेडक्वार्टर नागपुर में है. यू आर द ब्रिज बिटवीन दीज टू ग्रेट यूनियंस ऑफ स्टेट्स. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट द फाइट इज अबाउट. फाइट इज नॉट अबाउट पॉलिटिक्स, दैट इज सुपरफिशियल. व्हाट इज योर नेम? भलिंदर सिंह. The fight is about whether he, as a Sikh, is going to be allowed to wear his turban in India. Or he, as a Sikh, is going to be allowed to wear a kada in India. Or he, as a Sikh, is going to be able to go to a Gurdwara. That's what the fight is about. And not just for him. For all religions. Fight is also about, I can see here in the crowd, people from Tamil Nadu, Punjab, Haryana, I can see all these people. Telangana, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh. Right? So now, see, when I say Kerala, see, I've been a member of parliament for Kerala, so when I say Kerala, first, Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh now. So first, when you don't understand these things, you say Kerala is just a simple word. Or you say Punjab is a simple word. You know? But these are not simple words. This is your history, your language, your tradition, your entire imagination is in these words. And what the RSS is basically saying is that certain states are inferior to other states, certain languages are inferior to other languages, certain religions are inferior to other religions, certain communities are inferior to other communities. This is what the fight is about. We are of the opinion that whether you are from Punjab, Haryana, Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, all of you have your history, all of you have your tradition, all of you have your language, and every single one of them is as important as any other one. So how can you, the people from Tamil Nadu who are sitting here, what would you do if somebody told you you cannot speak Tamil? How would you feel? How would you react? That is the ideology of the RSS. That Tamil, Marathi, Bengali, Manipuri, these are all inferior languages. That's what the fight is about. It ends up in the polling booth. It ends up in Lok Sabha, Vidhan Sabha. But the fight is about what type of India we are going to have. Are we going to have an India where people are allowed to believe what they want to believe? People are allowed to respect what they want to respect, say what they want to say, listen to what they want to hear? Or are we going to have an India where only few limited people can decide what is going to happen? And the problem is these people don't understand India. वो समझ ही नहीं आती उनको. ये है क्या, इसकी history क्या है, उनको मालूम ही नहीं. It's like you imagine, जैसे यहाँ पे अब आप dinner खाएंगे, यहाँ पे आपको 3-course, 4-course meal मिलता है ना. पहले शुरू मतलब first course होता है, फिर main course आता है, फिर dessert आती है, होता है ना. इंडिया में कोई फर्स्ट कोर्स, सेकंड कोर्स, थर्ड कोर्स होता है? एक थाली मिलती है, सब कुछ उसके अंदर होता है। सही बात है ना। अब थाली में सब कुछ मिल जाता है, सब्जी दाल चावल सब मिल जाता है, मिलता नहीं मिलता है? वो स्वीट डिश भी उसी थाली में मिलता है, नहीं मिलता ना। तो इंडिया में नेचर ये है, सब कुछ एक साथ चलता है। अब अगर कोई आदमी थाली के सामने बैठ जाए और कहे भैया चावल दाल से ज्यादा जरूरी है और सब्जी की रैंकिंग सबसे नीचे है, तो क्या होगा? ये बीजेपी के लोग करते हैं। मतलब उनको समझ नहीं आती कि ये देश सबका है, ये देश मिलकर बना है। इसको इंडिया इज कॉल्ड यूनियन ऑफ स्टेट्स, इन द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन इज रिटन क्लियरली इंडिया दैट इज भारत इज ए यूनियन ऑफ स्टेट्स। What does it mean? It means it's a union of languages, it's a union of traditions, union of histories, union of music, of dance. वो कहते नहीं यूनियन नहीं, ये सब अलग अलग है और इन सब में से एक सबसे जरूरी है, एक सोच सबसे जरूरी है, उसकी उसका हेडक्वार्टर नागपुर में है। बाकी सबका कुछ लेना देना नहीं है। तो दैट इज व्हाट द फाइट इज अबाउट एंड यू आर एम्बेसडर्स। आई सेड यस्टरडे इन माय स्पीच, यू हैव कम फ्रॉम वन यूनियन ऑफ स्टेट्स एंड यू हैव कम टू अनदर यूनियन ऑफ स्टेट्स। यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड द यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स बिकॉज इट्स अ यूनियन ऑफ स्टेट्स एंड यू आर आर एम्बेसडर्स। You're the bridge between these two great unions of states. And you make us very proud because we understand what it meant for you to come here. We understand the difficulties, the struggles that you have had to deal with. It's not easy. But when you came here, you came with humility. You came with respect and you came with affection. You didn't come here and say, oh, you know, we're going to the United States and the United States is inferior to us. You didn't say, no, we're going to the United States, but we hate the United States. You became part of the United States. I'm sure you're proud of India and you're proud of the fact that you live in America. अब बीजेपी के सिस्टम में आपकी दो आइडेंटिटी हो ही नहीं सकती। यू कैन नॉट बी इंडियन एंड एट द सेम टाइम बी अमेरिकन। दैट इज व्हाट द फाइट इज अबाउट एंड दैट इज व्हाट वी आर ट्राइंग टू डू इन इंडिया। We are saying, look, don't spread hatred, spread love, don't be arrogant, be humble, don't disrespect people, respect people, respect traditions, respect religions, respect languages, respect communities.